first of all, where does it come from that we're not fulfilled in this life? And where does it come from that we feel like we're supposed to be?
In one sense, I would say anything that's east of Eden is already a sign of the fall and brokenness. I mean, God sent us out. So that alone says we're no longer in the geography of glory.
The New Testament talks about life as a life of suffering. Suffering with joy, to be sure, but still suffering and experiencing the frustrations of life.
Solomon lists work, he lists the accumulation of knowledge, material possessions. All these are good things, right?
Yeah.
They're not bad things. So how does something that's good, what does the relationship with something good look like versus when that good thing becomes an idol?
Idolatry is ultimately, I'm trying to find a way to be whole that does not have to do with submitting to the goodness of God, owning my own brokenness, and seeing the grace of God on my behalf.
Put God first and let everything else have its proper place. And those things can bring you happiness, not kind of an unalloyed, persistent happiness, but, you know, glimpses of heaven here on earth.
You look at Romans 8, and what does it begin with? There's no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. How does it end? There's nothing that can separate you from the love of God. I just have to confess, that's too good for me to believe. Mm-hmm. It would actually free me if I actually believed it just even a little bit more.